Yo. You rocking with the freshest, the cruise review on 4 Hot Fly.
NTP.
Yeah. Back with another album review. Might be in the running for a top album of the year. You know what I'm saying? We getting a lot of entries this year, man. Hip hop is having a good year this year, man. You know what I'm saying? Top qualified MCs, you know, throwing they rights out, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know, this one's gonna hit closer to home. You know what I'm saying? We probably got the most reviews from a company from the cruise review, probably. So, you know, a lot of y'all viewers might say, you know what I'm saying, niggas always doing one of them, you know what I'm saying? We already know. Whatever, you know what I'm saying? But, hey, it is what it is, man, you know what I'm saying? Quality, you know, over quantity. Say that, you know what I'm saying? So, real good top tier MC. We gonna get into, you know, some of the controversies on some of these, you know, tracks or whatever could be, maybe shoulda, coulda, woulda, maybe, you know what I'm saying? Detail or whatnot. But not to take too much time into it or not, but tell them who we rocking with, bro.
Benny the Butcher.
The Butcher is coming.
Yeah, this is our third time around. The last project was, we did a double album review with Conway. What was the name? You remember the name of that album? I can't remember on top of my head.
Was it
Plugs I Met Too.
Yeah, Plugs I Met Too.
Plugs I Met Too. It just popped in my head.
Conway's album.
Yeah, but y'all make sure y'all go back, y'all check that out.
Yeah,
Plugs I Met Too. And back in, we jumped off, what, I think it was this 2018?
Yep.
We did Benny the Butcher's first album, Tanner Talk 3.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all make sure y'all go back and check that one, too.
Yeah, check that
review. Check that review out. So,
yeah.
Yeah, so he's been a frequent participant, sort of say.
Yeah.
On the review tip.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, we try to go off, you know, off the map a little bit, give everybody a chance. But like I said, you know, quality over quantity. You know, we got some of, you know, the underground, maybe some of the unlikely, and, you know, Griselda might be likely, but that's all right. You know what I'm saying? We give everybody a fair shot. But, yeah, nevertheless, we're going to go into this Tanner Talk 4. You know what I'm saying? We picked some of our top, you know, 7 favorites off of here. And, you know, y'all can review it on y'all's own. And, you know, it's not to take away, because I know some of y'all be like, oh, y'all didn't even do, you know, those songs. We try to stay away from the songs that got videos. Let's just point that out of there. Because a lot of y'all was like that, you know what I'm saying, on the Magic album. They can't believe y'all didn't do this. Can't believe y'all didn't do that song. It's not the fact that, you know what I'm saying, we didn't want to do those songs. Like I said, we try to stay away from the songs that might be singles, you know what I'm saying, or they might, you know, might get the most play that everybody already heard.
Right.
We try to give, like, more detail to the B-side. So, you know, a lot of y'all viewers or whatever, you know what I'm saying, I can't remember one viewer's name, but you know what I'm talking about, you know, everybody don't need a...
Everybody don't need a channel.
Yeah, everybody don't need a channel, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you're right. Everybody don't need a channel,
exactly.
You're right.
Exactly. As well as you, nigga, because ain't nobody even watching. I checked your joint. Ain't nobody even watching your stuff, but you on our stuff. Talking about nobody need a channel. You right. So stay off our channel, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for the view, though. Straight up. Sorry I had to get that off. You know what I'm saying? I'm working on my aggressiveness, so to say. But anyway, yeah. let's get into some of these aggressive records, though. You know what I'm saying? What we going with first, bro?
We gonna kick it off with the second record, Back Two Times, featuring Stove God Cooks.
Let's get it.
They call me the Pot Race Man. Hey, yo, yo, yo. I gotta stamp that shit. Niggas trying to take my shit. Mr. Pot Race Man, that's me, nigga. Hey, yo, feel what I'm saying? The Butcher, nigga. Hey, yo, I'm eating caviar off your body that chopped in. When I quit, the guys I fed off narcotics, then got slim. My style mixed with Bodie James now and Tupac then. Don't compare me to no nigga that's not in the top 10. Don't do that. And all the number one, then another one, less than a year after it. I'm humble, but you fucking bum should be somewhere in practicing.
It's called. It's not the first record off the album, you know, it starts off with more than likely the first single. Yeah, we didn't go to, but from this, you know, starting off, man, I thought that was a dope entry.
Mm-hmm.
Stove God is on another planet right now. I don't know, bro. You know, you could go either way, you know, when it comes to Stove God. I mean, I understand it, but I don't quite understand why Busta kind of held him for so long, but that's for another subject later. You know what I'm saying? But these features that he's on, you know, he's bringing a wave to it that's kind of, you know, it's kind of, what is the word I'm looking for? Reminiscent of, you remember how, you know, when X came out, mm-hmm. he was featured on everybody's record, and
yeah.
you know what I'm saying? And then he started, you know, making his own records. Mm-hmm. Before, you know, it's kind of like that. It's kind of reminiscent of that. You know what I'm saying?
Like a resurgence.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? So, with this, man, it kind of brought that old school feel to it, you know, like with the, you know, when LOX started, you know, doing their things with Rough Riders and, you know, started creating like that hardcore, you know, lyrical street wave. This is what that reminded me of.
These Cartiers with the diamond solitaire hazardous. I swear these hoes fall out the air soon as they stare at the shit. Square packages, I stepped on them, Stairmaster bricks.
Dropped it in the pot, it came back, man.
Came on the way.
Soon as we unload this rental, we right back, man.
You know what I'm saying? When I heard that, and you know, it didn't have no takeaways. You know, Benny do what he does pretty much on every record. You know what I'm saying? He beats the track up, you know, lyrically. And Benny, this Tanner Talk 4 has a reminiscent vibe of Reasonable Doubt to me. Lyrically, I'll say that. You know what I'm saying? So, but like I said, it don't have no takeaways. So, I think starting off, I would go with this, 8.8. What you say, bro?
Back was cooking cocaine and designer. I turned 17 ounces to 39. Watch big homie lay that shit up on the heat like Harold Miner. I just dropped mine on the heat like Kyle Lowry. All the velo came from Bari. I'm with that rocket, I think I'm Barkley. And I ain't bring a chip home. Bitch, I brought a brick home. Did it off the flip phone. Had the feds in there tiptoe.
Plus, I want to add to it, on the production side, I believe that may have been an Alchemist beat. I could be wrong. Kind of sound like it might be.
Yeah, I think Alchemist did pretty much this whole album, I believe.
Yeah, yeah. So I kind of recognized that when I heard it. You know, dope record. The feature, you know, like you said, it's kind of like a resurgence of when DMX was out, going on different people's records, then putting out his own. And I think Stove God Cooks is bringing like a different flavor, like on the East Coast tip.
Absolutely.
Like it's not the drill sort of rap, but he's got a different, you know what I'm saying, sort of flavor with it. You know what I'm saying? Plus he can hold a tune too.
Yeah, absolutely. You know,
kind of remind me of like an East Coast Pimp C.
Yeah, I knew he was going.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Yep.
Especially with this single he put out, All in the Game. It's the Game, I think, something like that.
Yeah.
A single, the video, y'all check that out. But I think overall, man, I would give this record probably like an 8.7, something like that. 8.7, 8.8.
Yeah.
I gotta go along with that.
Yeah, I think that's fair, bro. Yeah. Straight up. So let's get into this number two record off the K7 that we picked.
Next record is gonna be Super Plug.
Let's get it.
You know me, right? I keep it real with it ugly in the streets. They talk computer on these records. Pull this tool out my boot and y'all gonna shoot towards the exit. When you wrong compressing, you might look at a new car, a watch or a new loft as a few small investments. Suit cost the Lexus, the line hot. They wanna hear the truth on the record. Since I blew more, the feds got through off direction.
I thought that was a dope title, man. It really reminded me back when, you know, Nori made Super Thug. I don't know if that's what he was going with, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, you know, that reminiscent, you know, kind of vibe is dope to me. But yeah, I really like that. I like the chorus more than anything. He didn't put too much on it, you know what I'm saying? It was a laid back chorus, but it was enough.
Keep it real with everything I do, and everything I say, and everything I love. My only wish was get my niggas rich, hold my family down, find a plug.
Kind of like, you know, how Kiss do his choruses. You don't put too much on it, but he gives you just enough. Or you could say Havoc too. You know what I'm saying? That kind of vibe to it. But yeah, I thought it was dope, man. And you know, the subject tone was even doper of it. You know, the cadence was dope. You know what I'm saying? It's just it's really good to hear lyricism being back in the forefront. You know what I'm saying? Benny is excellent when it comes to that, man. It's no takeaways whatsoever. You know what I'm saying? He could be arrogant, but you hear more humility on this one with it. You know what I'm saying? So I think I would go probably in the same standing. I probably go with an 8.8 on this one as well.
They want my supplier, but he flew off to Texas. They identify the bosses through y'all possessions. Last 2 years, I've been running through all contestants. 4 pound of crack and shit you off your vest.
Yeah, when I first heard this record, man, it took me back to a Rock Marciano record.
Okay.
You probably remember this. It was off the Marcialago album. Richard Gere.
Oh, Richard. Yeah.
It took me, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like the same type of vibe on it. You know what I'm saying? It's like one of those ones you just throw on, you just ride to. You know, it's like, I think I watched the interview with Pound 448, and he said something like that was one of his favorite records at the time, where he just, as soon as he get in the car, he had to throw that on.
Yeah.
And this is kind of like one of those records for me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The production is just, it's a real vintage type of sound, you know.
Absolutely.
And I think Alchemist probably done this too.
Yeah, I believe so.
Like Alchemist, yeah.
Yeah.
Done this too, man. So it's just one of those, it's like one of those Thinking Man's records, you know. He's just going into some of his back history in the street.
Yeah.
And just detailing it, you know, to his best ability, man. So
absolutely.
I thought that was, you know, dope. And it, and this record too kind of reminds me of a Reasonable Doubt type of vibe too. So
absolutely. Yeah. Yep. Glad you said that.
Yeah, so I would give this probably 8.8, 8.9.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fair.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So let's go with this number three, bro. What we got is the title.
Number three record is gonna be Weekends in the Paris. He's from Bodie James.
Word to every block in my city, they heard I got it. And my track record certainly show I deserve a homage. Your coke burning product was only a learning process. Stepping on the brick of fentanyl for you heard about it. And my phone used to ring so much you get nervous around me. Cut ties with the game, the same shit that certified me. On my clientele going Mr. Customer Service by me.
Yeah, man, I like that record, man. I think it's the track that was sampled. I don't know if Alchemist did that or not, but
yeah, probably so.
I don't know. It seems like a real, real old school feel to it. You know, when it comes on, I can hear multiple people on that track. I can hear Jay on there. I can hear Nas. I can hear Currency on there. I can hear Kiss on there. SP. You know what I'm saying? I can hear multiple artists on there, man. You know what I'm saying? That track just speaks for itself, but the cadence more than anything, I think, stood out greatly on this record. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? On Benny and Boldy. Boldy just has like a laid back feel to all his, you know, records. You know what I'm saying? Where he just brings like a different kind of vibe to it. You know what I'm saying? A melodic kind of vibe.
Treated the same way that I live with death. Shit weighing a nigga down. Refraining from different stages of self-neglect. Give me chills in my vein. Taking whatever's left. From everything that was taken in blatant disrespect. For good, better, best. We ain't traded for less.
But yeah, all together, I thought it was great. I don't think, you know, it ain't really no add-ons or takeaways to it whatsoever. I think I would go a little bit more with this one. I go with a 9.1. What would you say?
Oh, yeah? Oh, man. Yeah, this to me was one of those laid-back smoker type records. Like when you said, one artist that identified most with me with this record was Currency.
Absolutely.
It just sound like one of those Currency type of laid back, you know, rolling up, kicking back.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, but I mean, it was dope he put Bodie James on this record because I think this fits his style.
Yeah.
And you know his tone and the way that he does his verses or whatever. But I mean, this record was still a good record. I think me myself, I probably would give it maybe a 7.8.
Okay.
Something like that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't my favorite, you know, record, but it wasn't, you know what I'm saying? It was still a
good record.
Yeah, still a good record.
Absolutely.
Dope record.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's go with this number 4, bro. What's the title we got?
10 More Commandments featuring Diddy.
Oh, let's get it.
Hey, yo, make my shit sound godly. Like that.
What you coming, nigga?
I'm gonna tell you like this. It's all in your mindset.
Yeah.
Let's go. Be free.
Soon as they let me eat, know the streets was my expertise. I kept the street contacts with my connects, so they let me eat. I'm a rapper, but I was a drug trafficker before I left the streets. These 10 more crack commandments. Frank Wright, rest in peace. Number 20, gotta be to make sure that you count the money. Zigas and fives on the hundreds.
Don't make
call
sense.
That back. Don't never burn the plug, dog. That silly shit. I had to mention it since this one wasn't on Biggie list. You knew you have a hard time comprehending it. I mean, risking 6-figure minutes for pennies. It's kind of ridiculous.
Hard body. Yeah. Hard body, yo. Probably one of the most hard body records this year, man. I think, you know, him going back and relating more, you know, to relate with this era was phenomenal. It's something that everybody need to hear, whether you sling or you don't sling. You know what I'm saying? You need to hear it because a lot of these, you know, commandments apply to niggas that just got a regular job doing, you know, trying to, you know, be computer thugs, so to say. Keyboard thugs, you know what I'm saying? Well, whatever. We'll get more to that on this Dave East review. We're gonna do upcoming. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but I thought it was phenomenal, man. Hey, personally, with me, it ain't nothing to review. That record's a 10.10 to me. Mm. Straight up. Just with the title, how he addressed everything, you know what I'm saying? It was, you know, brutally honest. Might be some things that niggas don't want to hear but need to hear. You know what I'm saying? Putting Diddy on there, the ad lib, was everything. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it gets a 10.10 for me. What you say?
Number 12, I noticed when a little 12. Step for something, up off of anything. Respect is like a shield. Yo, you gotta go wherever this shit takes you. You doing what you will. Take your keeps, use your steel, and hopefully you shoot to kill.
It's definitely a phenomenal record, man. It was definitely an epic move for him to do a sequel to Biggie's 10 Crack Commandments.
Absolutely.
And relating it to this day and age, you know. Because like he said on, I can't remember which one, but one of the commandments he's talking about, social media.
Being tricky, Big couldn't even approach it. When he was slinging and toting, this wasn't even a focus. No social media posting, greedy emotions. Niggas chase fame and not the money, that's broke shit. They'll be on whole shit.
Saying when Biggie was around, it was no such thing as Facebook and Instagram and TikTok and all this other stuff, you know. So, so I think it was a genius move for him to make something that's relatable to this day and age, you know.
Absolutely.
And also putting Diddy on at the end, and you can tell Diddy got some major influence from Jay Electronica. Some of the things he was saying at the end, I was like, yeah, he was, you know.
Yeah.
He was building with Jay Electronica, you know.
Absolutely.
So,
you know what I'm saying? We are the original man. The black man is God. And the black woman gave birth to the black man. You can imagine what she is.
Some of the things he was saying at the end, I was like, yeah, he was, you know.
Yeah.
He was building with Jay Electronica, you know.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, man, I think overall it's just a phenomenal record. Yeah. On the production side, I think he chose a dope beat for the production.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't try to do it too like new wave.
Yeah.
It was kind of like in the middle. Like, you know, it wasn't so vintage, but it wasn't so this era either. It was just, you know, kind of stuck in the middle.
Very
and it was kind of mid-tempo, I would say. You know, so yeah, I think I would give this record probably a 9.5, man.
Yeah. I think that's fair.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Off the charts.
Dope. Let's go with this number 5 record. What we got as the title?
It's gonna be Tyson versus Ali featuring Kanye the Machine.
Yeah, let's get it.
Tyson versus Ali. Tyson versus Ali. Everybody wanna know who would be better, Tyson. Yeah, the greatest to the greatest, like Boston versus the Lakers. Question, do your legacy rest depending on where you rank amongst the current and the late? If so, I feel like I'm straight, but rapping and selling weight. I just had them genetic triggers from the same movement, only for your amusement. It's funny to me, y'all do it. Truth is, while I'm killing shit, count with you somewhere rooting. That nigga still sound the same, put out something exclusive.
Pure dopeness, man.
Yeah.
Love the title. Love the aspect of the title. You know what I'm saying? The cadence and the lyrics to match was phenomenal. You know what I'm saying? I think it was dope for him to, you know, relate that to, you know, him and his cousin's relationship, especially with, you know, Conway. Everybody knew Conway in Buffalo. You know, he been rhyming for years. You know what I'm saying? And you know, they say Conway sound the same, you know, almost 20 years ago. You know what I'm saying? As he do now. So, you know, before he got shot and everything, you know.
Hey, yo, Benny, I remember what we used to do to the fiends. That's why I feel so good to see you doing your thing. Don't get distracted by the noise, don't let it ruin your thing. Try to pick you off, but that's really your moving screen. Awful thing, my bitch don't do the Gucci bag, she usually do the Celine. So pills in the trenches, that's pharmaceutical cream.
His voice tone changed and whatnot, but, you know, it was dope to see Conway kind of relate that back to Benny, you know, giving them, you know, the format to follow. You know what I'm saying? Sort of kind of like, you know, Ali did to Tyson. You know, Tyson came in to avenge Ali's, you know, loss. You know, he told Ali, you know, he was going to make up for his loss. And, you know what I'm saying? He did exactly that with his first match. You know what I'm saying? So, it was dope to relate that, you know, to that. But I think overall, I would go with this with a solid 9.0. What would you say, bro?
Yeah, man. Hey, man, you took my, you took my saying right out of me. I was about to go there with the Tyson and Ali thing when Tyson fought Larry Holmes. Because yeah, I think that's the guy he fought.
Yep.
Because Larry Holmes was a guy... was a fighter Ali used to train.
Yep.
But Holmes finally stepped into the professional world, and he brought it to Ali.
Yep.
And Mike Tyson, from his very jump, he always said that once he get to that point, he wants to avenge Ali's honor, basically.
Yep.
So he actually did that. He beat Larry Holmes.
Killed him. Slaughter.
Yeah.
Slaughtered that man.
Yeah, man. But I think that's a great concept also to name it Tyson versus Ali, because those two fighters were, legendary fighters during their time period, and people always compare them. Like, who's the greatest? And the same thing's happening with Benny and Conway.
Yeah.
Even though they kind of on the same team, people always is like, well, who you think's better? Who got the better album?
Yeah.
Who's, and Benny started his verse off of that. You already. But I love the production on it. Dope laid back beat. Something to ride to. I get this another high key rating, man. Probably a same, probably 9.0.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think that's fair, bro. Mm-hmm. So let's go with this number 6 in the mix. Who we got for the title?
Number 6 is going to be Uncle Bun featuring 38 Special.
Let's get it.
Hey, I just bought a kilo from my dog in B-Lo. Mixing fentanyl with diesel. That shit they selling clogging needles. Niggas switch so I don't talk to people.
Uh-uh.
Two clips, that's enough shots for you. Yeah. You're all to ego.
Flight coming in from Puerto Rico. Landing on the East Coast, nigga. And now I'm driving cars with keyholes. Y'all niggas just getting fresh and y'all talking fashion. I'm a veteran, the Yoel Letterman with the army patches. Turn my elite, underground king like I'm Uncle Bun. Another run.
I think that was a salute to Bun B from Underground Kings, UGK. Rest in peace, Pimp C. You know what I'm saying? I love that track, man. I know a lot of people don't relate to 38 Special because of his voice. You know what I'm saying? I know a lot of people that said they don't really particularly like, how he... sound off his words or pronounces his words.
Yeah.
And I know, what I'm saying? There's a couple of, I heard a couple of people say the same as Stove God Cuts, but let me just say something on subject but off subject. A lot of y'all dudes don't like New York niggas. Let's just be honest.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of y'all, because it was the same thing with West Side Gun. When he first came out, a lot of y'all ain't like West Side. A lot of y'all jumped on the wave. And it's going to be the same thing with Stove God Cooks. And maybe 38 Special too.
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna have a run, nigga. We got rich off the right vision. To get the squares from here to there was a light mission. I put some, nigga, I got a hand at the right scriptures. But y'all take the stand and land me in tight fences. Fuck a life sentence. Pray God hand me the right riches and turn this one brick to a family of white bitches.
These gonna be the same thing. A lot of y'all, the ones y'all saying y'all don't really like them or whatever, when, you know what I'm saying, come out with a hot single or hot record, a lot of y'all gonna jump on the way. But let's just be honest. Niggas don't like New York niggas. I'll give you an example real quick. In the South, no pun intended, but in the South, a lot of who's the favorite New York MC the niggas in the South love?
Cam'ron. Dipset, Cam'ron, all day.
Them same niggas that love Cam, no takeaways from Cam. This is not a diss or whatsoever. But them same niggas that love Cam and Dipset was the same ones thinking that the Lox, the LOX, was going to lose the verses. A lot of niggas wasn't seeing what actually happened before it happened because of being fans of Cam and Dipset. Mm-hmm. A lot of niggas, you know what I'm saying, they love Dipset niggas, you know what I'm saying, but niggas from other boroughs in the city, they don't really niggas don't really like Nas like that. Let's
Mob
just
Deep.
Niggas can't stand Mob Deep.
Yeah.
Because of what?
Because of Tupac, of course.
I
grew up with the shit.
Yeah, a lot of niggas never heard a lot of Mobb Deep songs. They won't reference a lot of Mobb Deep songs because of just not liking.
Let me get off on that too, because you always get off on that from your opinion. Niggas need to hear from a Louisville perspective, because nigga, when I was in high school, and nigga, when I liked the Nas and Mobb Deep, and y'all niggas was on fucking Tupac, yeah, you know, Mobb Deep, you know what I'm saying? Them, you know, little niggas, just because, you know, Tupac had a bigger, you know what I'm saying, I guess, attitude on camera and this, that, and the third.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And, you know, always, you know, kind of downgraded Mobb Deep or whatever. That's the reason why y'all didn't like Mobb Deep.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
But then later on, about 10 years later, you know, when Mobb Deep came out with Murder Music and all that,
yeah,
you know, y'all started getting on Mobb Deep's dick,
yeah,
later on and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Yeah. So, yeah.
A lot of niggas don't
That's
like...
That's coming from a nigga from Louisville.
Straight up.
Not a nigga from New York. So.
Yeah. let me get off of it. But I know niggas gonna say, "Oh, you just saying that because you know."
Nah, that's before I even met.
Yeah.
Oh, that's way before I met her. I was listening to Nas and Mobb Deep.
Straight up.
One of my first cassettes I bought was "It Was Written" when I got for Christmas from Moms and Keith Murray. So you can't tell me nothing.
Yeah, straight up.
I had a Keith Murray cassette, and I had the Nas cassette.
Straight up. This is coming from him. This ain't me, but I just wanted to make that clear because it's funny, you know what I'm saying, how people jump on the wave, but I never got a chance to say that, but I want to make that clear. A lot of y'all niggas, just be honest, you don't like New York niggas. You don't like the rhymes. You just don't like niggas from New York, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Certain people. But it's funny because a lot of y'all, you know what I'm saying, the way you dress, your clothes and everything, your sneakers, you get it from New York.
Yeah. Yeah, yep. Yeah.
You get it from New York.
Yeah,
y'all like certain niggas from New York. You don't like a bunch of Queens niggas in Queens, but you like Nori.
Yeah.
Make that make sense. You don't like certain niggas from Queens, but you like Nori. You don't really particular Mega. You don't particular Royal Flush.
Yeah.
Mike Geronimo. Whatever, you know what I'm saying? Capone.
Infamous Mob,
you know what I'm saying? Havoc. But you like Nori.
Yeah.
To like Nori, you gotta like these other niggas too. Let's just be honest. You know what I'm saying? You don't like M.O.P., you know what I'm saying? You don't like Half a Mill or whatever, but you like Busta.
Yeah, Jay-Z.
You like Jay-Z?
Yeah, Buster's a Long Island nigga. A lot of niggas thought Buster, me too. I thought Buster was a Brooklyn nigga. But he, you know, Long Island.
Long Island, straight up.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Even, you know, let's just be honest, Meth. You know, he raps Staten Island, but he's from Long Island too. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, I just wanted to make that clear because a lot of y'all niggas be hiding in the shade, you know what I'm saying, giving little references. And the reference, you know, overall is you just don't like New York niggas. You know what I'm saying? And until they hit a popular stance, then you come in. Because it was the same way with Griselda. Niggas wasn't feeling Benny like that. It wasn't when he first came. Niggas wasn't feeling Conway. You know, what's that nigga with the funny face they used to say?
Yeah.
Now all of a sudden y'all Conway fans. Now all of a sudden y'all West Side fans. Y'all on Instagram. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's corny to me. Like, you know, but that's everywhere. That's not just around where we are. That's everywhere. You know what I'm saying? But I just wanted to point that out. But yeah, getting back to this record, I thought the back and forth was dope. I like the vibe that Benny and 38 Special have, not just on this record, but a lot of their records. You know what I'm saying? I really thought it was dope. The music was there. You know, it was sounding great. Everything about it.
The results you get when you're the reason the culture shift. Don't believe in that vulture shit. Had to feed my associates. I make sure everybody eat. Yeah, I think like a socialist. $1 million empire from a piece of a broken brick.
Probably go with the, I'll say maybe an 8.6, 8.5 on this record.
Mm.
What you say, bro?
Yeah, this is one of my favorite records on the project, man. You know, shout out to Benny and 38 Special. You know, aka the Trust Game.
Yeah, yep.
You know,
yep.
They got a little thing going on. So, you know, I thought the chemistry was, dope. And, you know, to say people, you know, like you were saying about 38 Special, they don't like his voice. Really, I think it's very unique because he doesn't really sound like a New York, you know, the way that he pronounces his word, he almost got like a country type of.
Yeah.
Accent a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, I thought he was maybe like somewhere from Philly.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, somewhere like that. He's got like a kind of, like a country.
A swing to it.
Yeah, like a Southern. You
say the same thing about how I talk. My accent being kind of in the middle or whatever.
In the middle and shit.
You know what
I'm saying?
He got that kind of twang, but yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. But I think that's what makes a artist, you know what I'm saying, stand out.
Absolutely.
You know what
I'm
saying?
I'm glad you pointed that out. Absolutely.
So, I mean, and then a lot of times people ain't really heard a person's music like that. You know, they judging off of one or two records.
Absolutely.
You really got to do your knowledge and go back and, you know, listen to different, you know, features and things like that. You know, don't just listen to the feature that he's on that mainstream popular type of artists, you know, check out Flea Lord and Ito's album. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
You know, Far Rock America or whatever.
Absolutely.
Rock America, you know.
Yeah. It's just funny to me how niggas point that out, but when you say something about one of these drill rappers or, you know, somebody like Young Thug or Gunna, you saying that you don't really particular, like, I don't really feel that song. Oh, you just hating.
When you hating.
You know what I'm saying? But when you say they hating, it's like, nah, I ain't hating. I just don't like the nigga.
Yeah.
Nah, you can't co-align the two.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's funny to me about, you know, the wave riders just, you know, just ride a wave until another one comes. Then you jump off of it, hop on another one.
Y'all niggas be high key all weekend music and shit.
Yeah.
That Gunna shit is weekend shit, bro.
I can't,
you know what I'm saying, nigga? I'm about to go to work. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting up in the morning. I'm not about to throw on fucking Gunna. I'm going to throw on Richard Gere, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like,
straight up.
What type of shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah, man. Yeah. But, you know, not to get off subject, but yeah, but, I get this. I probably would get this an 8.8, 8.9. It's a high key record to me.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair, bro. So we got this last record, this number 7. You know what I'm saying? off the Ten of Talk for our picks, K7. What we got, bro, is the title.
Last record is going to be Guerrero featuring West Side Gun.
No better time than now. Let's get it.
Yeah.
I was barely known, but see, I bodied every flow. That's when the rubber bands of weight just made 97 hold. I've been warning you, I'm Scarface versus Sosa on both sides. These goat lines can make you feel like you rip off a coat line, yeah. I counted out 51 bands when a coat crying. I'm Joe Pesci, 38 from the movie. It's not a prop, though. My dog in a county on Echo Long with an iPhone.
Yeah, man, if you know your wrestling like West Side Gun, dude. You know what I'm saying? Me and bro do. Because even before we was Griselda fans, you know what I'm saying? That's something we did too. Yeah. So don't say, y'all, these niggas just got on wrestling because of Griselda. Nah, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Nah.
I was a kid.
Straight up. On the real. We came up on that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you can reference this title track. It's one of the, you know, the illest wrestlers that, you know, came out of nowhere. You know what I'm saying? Mr. Lie, Cheat, and Steal, Eddie Guerrero, rest in peace. You know what I'm saying? One of the great Mexican wrestlers, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Family still heavy in it, too. You know what I'm saying? So, but this track was dope, man. I didn't think they put too much on it. I thought it was enough what it was, you know what I'm saying? It didn't have too much sauce on it. It was exactly what it needed, you know what I'm saying? West Side ain't go off, you know, the map or whatever, like a lot of you niggas that really don't, ain't fans and really don't, you know what Griselda does. You know, his choruses or whatever. Nigga, just say you're not a fan. It's easy. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot easier. You know, but West Side did his thing, you know. Benny definitely did his thing. His lyrics was top tier on this record. I'll probably go with this record with what bro said last time, a 8.9. What would you say, bro?
Yeah, this is one of my favorite key records too, man. You know, dope collaboration once again. I think West Side's verse is kind of like the way he done it was like one of those last minute joints, you know what I'm saying? Because the way he ended it off, ended it off kind of off key or whatever.
Yeah,
you
absolutely.
Know what I'm saying? And they was just like, fuck it, leave that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Just go in and, you know, do your thing, you know.
Did the stem, did the willie in his wheelchair, show girls, man, work for jewels, bitch, you still here?
I'm still here.
Bitch, your spot got you being coach in it. Bag of whole chicken, slice alone, and she's...
There's a lot of records out there that work like that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Where it's kind of off key a little bit, but
yeah,
you know, dope collaboration, dope production. It's just one of those sound like a cipher to me.
Yeah, it does. I'm glad you referenced that.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, just one of them cipher type records, man.
And that's probably what it may have been. Why his verse was so short, honestly. Mm-hmm. Might have been a cipher. Might have been a, you know, a freestyle, a quick one, you know, that Benny just decided to keep on it.
Yeah,
you know,
I like
what I'm
saying? Yeah, I like that line he's spinning there too. He's like, fiend doing the wop, stupid nigga to make my phone hot.
Fiends dancing doing the wop, stupid nigga made my phone hot. Then the sniffer did the robot.
I listened to that. That stood out to me the
most,
you know.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
That's for y'all niggas that don't like West Side.
Yeah, straight up. On the real. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but I would give it probably a 8.9 again.
Okay,
high key.
What would you give the overall albums we didn't, you know, songs we didn't
do? The overall project in total, I think I would give this project probably a 8.7.
Okay. Yeah.
How you feel?
Yeah, I think all together with the songs we didn't do, lyrics and everything, cadence, I'd probably go with an 8.9.
Okay.
I think I would total it out as an 8.9, you know what I'm saying, straight up.
Okay.
But I think, you know, like I said, it reminds me of Reasonable Doubt. So I think moving forward, this next album or EP, whatever, it might be the one. This might be Benny's one. It might, this next one might be, you know what I'm saying, a 9.9 rating. I think it's only gonna elevate, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, it's no takeaways, you know what I'm saying? But I did want to see, I'm gonna be honest with you, bro. I did want to see a Benny and Gibbs feature. I don't think we're gonna get that.
We have to get that on the next, yeah, on the next either Cruise Catch Up, yeah, or Crash and Burn.
Crash and Burn. Yeah, we'll talk more about that. So y'all stay tuned for that. Yeah. But you know what I'm saying. But yeah, great album. You know what I'm saying. Review for this time. And, you know, keep giving us some more, Biddy. Great work. Shout out to The Butcher.
Yeah.
But nevertheless, you rocking with the freshest, the Cruise Review on 4-Eye Fly.
And TP.
Out of here, yo. Get y'all some sunshine, man. Get this cold weather up out of here. I'm sick of it, man. Get it out of here. Yeah, that's from a New York nigga, too. I don't care. I'm sick of it. We out of here, yo. Easy.